Upon sailing an hour northwest of the old Spanish port city of Cartagena de Indias, one is bound to come across a group of 30 islands that are collectively known as the Islas de Rosario. Sporting pristine white sand beaches, crystal clear turquoise water, and exotic fauna, the island is nothing short of a dream tourist destination. Even now, thousands of people visit Cartagena Islands all year round, be them tourists or locals. But once you go a little further into the Caribbean Sea, you'll come across an island which has been left relatively untouched in recent times. And guess who had a sprawling hacienda in this secluded location? Yes, you guessed it right. It's none other than famed dealer Pablo Escobar. La Isla Grande presently houses 800 natives who mostly depend on fishing and farming for sustenance. Isolated from the modern world, the island still lacks running water and electricity and has a daily life that is quiet, rustic, and simple. But that was not the case when Mr. Escobar had his hacienda built on this island. Things were quite different at that time. Welcome back to another new episode. Hope you're all doing great. And today, I will expose everything about the secret island mansion of Pablo Escobar, which no one has ever done before. Are you excited? I know you are. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. At the far side of La Isla Grande, right between the tropical forest and the Caribbean Sea, lies a huge complex of resorts and buildings. Pablo Escobar, the man with an estimated net worth of $30 billion, was responsible for smuggling around 80% of the world's cocaine during his prime time. He was the leader of the Medellin cartel that smuggled over 15 tons of cocaine into the United States daily. And such a man had quite the penchant for luxury and grandiose. Rightfully branded as one of the world's richest men, Pablo Escobar's lifestyle lived up to his name. Apart from his barrage of luxury cars, Pablo owned 15 planes and 6 helicopters. He had beautiful mansions all around Colombia, with one at Puerto Triunfo, known as the Hacienda Napolis, where Escobar had his zoo with rhinoceroses, giraffes, elephants, and even a dinosaur park made with authentic dinosaur bones from prehistoric times. He was also known to have funded his favorite football team, Atletico Nacional. So much so that they went on to win the Copa Libertadores as the first Colombian team. These football club investments of his were later exposed in a documentary called The Two Escobars, which detailed the amount of corruption and bribery rampant in the world of Colombian football at this time. Now let's come back to Escobar's mansion on La Isla Grande. It's completely cut off from the modern world. It has no running water or electrical power lines. But this island got the attention of one vacationer who built a palace, now abandoned. Pablo's plans were quite over the top, to be honest. He allegedly commissioned an entire complex featuring a mansion, apartments that opened up to the sea, a palm court with a gigantic swimming pool, and a helipad. This palace gives us a glimpse of the lifestyle of Pablo Escobar. At the height of his notoriety, he struggled to find a place to store all of the money he was earning from trafficking narcotics. The area, which once was a playground of the country's most notorious barons, has now fallen into despair. Housing up to 300 rooms for guests and his cartel men, Escobar spared no expense at his property. He had gold shower heads in his bathrooms and a playground that resembled a strip of Miami's South Beach in the 80s. Access to the island was not publicly available, and one had to take a special boat from Cartagena. Most of the residents live around the main town of Arica, where currently a lot of recycling and conservation projects are on the way. Back then, there were no signs or public tours inside the Escobar estate. After hours of trekking through the Caribbean forests and boating on a canoe through dense swamp lands, one has to take bicycles and finally reach the mansion on foot. Constructed mostly with white concrete, the mansion's entry features an old but beautiful tiled pathway. Right next to it, one might spot a 30-foot luxury speedboat lying on its side, currently taken over by tropical flowers and dense foliage. The entire complex, which once stood as a testament to the power and influence of Pablo Escobar and the Medellin cartel, has now been entirely reclaimed by nature. The once vibrant and lush gardens now house a family of giant wild pigs. On stepping inside the main mansion, the eye sees exquisite decorations of white tile and marble, with cracked walls still displaying the color schemes of pastel blue and coral pink from the 80s. There's a lobby leading into a giant courtyard, covered with palm trees overlooking the Caribbean Sea. Although there are no swimmers that currently take a stroll at the pool, reports of clothes lying close to the pool have recently resurfaced. Is Escobar coming back again in a new garb? Or is it just harmless island residents taking a gander? What do you guys think? Let us know in the comments. Inside the La Isla Grande, the party scene was once quite rampant. Although the vibrant parties were filled with pomp and show, access was certainly limited. Simply stepping foot anywhere near this place in the late 80s or 90s would have one killed on sight. Escobar was known to maintain an army of ruthless sicarios, led by Popeye John Jairo Velasquez, a notorious serial killer who has a kill count of 300 people, having planned the deaths of over 3,000 people, including his wife. During Escobar's time, Colombians had quite a complicated relationship with the man. His criminal activity has been extensively documented, but even with that, Escobar carefully maintained a Robin Hood-like image with the lower and middle classes of Colombia. He built huge football fields in the barrios and slowly organized teams and leagues for the children. The street vendors of Cartagena in Las Palenqueras still sell t-shirts with his face alongside replica jerseys of the Colombian hero Real Madrid forward James Rodriguez, whom Escobar had a liking for. Ever since Pablo Escobar met his demise, the Medellin cartel took a big hit. Although the crime scene in Colombia continued after his death, the country underwent a great change, especially in the world of tourism. After Escobar passed away, Hacienda Nepolis was claimed by the Colombian government, and currently, there are plans of turning it into a substance museum, complete with a theme park and zoo, while Escobar's exotic animals run wild in Puerto Tifuno. Opened in 2008, the remnants of Pablo's privileged life includes private bullfighting pits, swimming pools, tennis courts, and even one of his substance-smuggling planes that now sits on the top of the entrance gate. It's one of Colombia's most unique attractions. In his trip to the Medellin cartel, located in Doradal Antigua in the Magdalena River Valley, Hacienda Nepolis gained fame as the home of the substance trafficker Pablo Escobar. This sprawling estate is now a theme park with exotic animals like hippos, a water park, a savanna tour, a Jurassic Park exhibit, and the remains of Escobar's car collection, and so much more. Escobar's private zoo was home to some 200 animals, including elephants, ostrich, zebras, camels, and giraffes. Many of the creatures were smuggled into the country on board Escobar's planes. After he died in 1993, most of these animals were transferred to the zoo. However, 4 hippos were left behind, which multiplied by 2016, and 40 hippos lived in that area. The potentially dangerous animals have damaged farms and inspired fear among the locals. The authorities began castrating male hippos to control the population. Pablo Escobar's mansion at La Isla Grande has also come under government control, and unlike Hacienda Nepolis, which is more or less maintained, the property at La Isla Grande is now in ruins. Just like before the heydays of Pablo Escobar, life continues on the island with its simple and slow pace, with the residents now enjoying a somewhat better life with the boom in tourism. It's quite funny and ironic that Pablo Escobar, the man who was once hunted by the governments of Colombia and the United States, is currently funding an entire tourism economy with his standing history of crime. Netflix has also made an interesting amount of money based on Escobar's pursuits in South America. But as time swiftly comes to take life away, the once vibrant and bustling scene at La Isla Grande, replete with sicarios, supermodels, high government officials, and dealers, is now silent, still, and under the occupation of nature. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment section below. Do you want to visit any of these billion-dollar mansions? Also, like, share, and subscribe to my channel to never miss an update. Thanks for watching.